Hello and welcome then for another MotoGP Fantasy Preview Live. This time it's for the Austrian Grand Prix for round 13 of the MotoGP World Championship in 2022. Yes, we really are cracking on with the races, aren't we? Not many to go in the 2022 season, and the championship at the moment is starting to hot up indeed. I think it's 22 points the advantage for Fabio this weekend, but Pekka Bagnaia is the big man on the move, closing in all the way from almost 90 points back, I believe he was, to now 49 back from Quartararo. So for this week, then we've got a very special guest joining us indeed. He is, of course, a two-time world champion and current LCR Honda rider, Alex Marquez. We'll bring Alex up on screen now and say a very big hello. Alex, welcome to the Fantasy Preview. How are you doing, and are you looking forward to this weekend?
Hello, Zach. Hello, everybody. Happy to be in Austria. It's one of my favorites, but it's one that I like it. Just not the track, the layout, also the atmosphere, everything is so nice. So it's a pleasure to be here again, and yeah, looking forward to that new corners, the 2A and 2B, to see how we can approach it and how it will be for us and our bike.
Well, we'll come on to the corners in just a very short minute indeed, but I believe just before you came on air, you actually showed me some very special, I think they were Thai boxing shorts that you've been gimping today or something. They look pretty cool indeed.
Yeah, I did I have here with the name, TGP, everything. I did an interview just 5 minutes ago, and yeah, they give me this present to me. So yeah, it's a nice present to go to Thai.
Well, we look forward to seeing you walk into the Thai GP paddock in those shorts then, Alex. Maybe we'll have to get you to swear to that one. But no, certainly, exactly. We're looking forward to going back to Thailand, of course, first time in 3 years that we'll be there. But as you did very briefly mention, the new layout, of course. Have you seen, I presume today you've walked the track already, or maybe you'll do that after this. It's going to be very different from last year.
Yeah, I went with the bicycle this morning a little bit to make 1 hour just easy. And yeah, I passed there 2 times. I mean, in the pictures, looks very different compared to reality. I mean, I think will be a big challenge for everybody, big challenge, especially for the manufacturers, all the manufacturers. But KTM were here with Pedrosa, so they have already some data and some adjustments about electronic and all this. But for the rest, will be a big challenge to see which one can fix it more that point with the electronic side, with everything, which gear we need to use. Looks like from KTM info that around 6 seconds is slower the track because it's not straight and we lose a lot of time. So will be interesting to be there and to see. I think from security we will gain a lot because Tortue in the past, especially on race or on wet, were quite dangerous. So I think will be good, and we need to see if we need to modify something or it's okay. But looks great.
Well, it sounds like it could be a bigger change than we expected, perhaps. Obviously, you say 6 seconds there, that's quite a lot. But coming on to the reason why you're here, Alex, of course, we do need to help you choose our fantasy team for us. So we'll bring our team up now, because last time out in Britain, we had this team, which consisted of Aleix Espargaró and Fabio Quartararo, then also Aprilia for the constructor, and Andrea Bastianini and Marco Bezzecchi. Now, obviously, wasn't the best weekend in the world for Aleix or Fabio. Aleix still recovering from that now actually confirmed broken heel. But certainly, Bastianini had a good ride, and Bezzecchi wasn't far off either. Just looking at this, of course, we have two Ducatis there, an Aprilia and a Yamaha. What do you think of kind of those manufacturers' chances around Austria?
I mean, Austria is quite red. I mean, if you think in red, it's Ducati. In the past, we'll see with the new layout and all this that I think some advantage that they have in the first partial can be a little bit less with the new chicane. But yeah, I think, for sure, Pecco will be in a really good form because, you know, he's coming in a really good way, really good form after the summer break, but also in Holland. So for sure, if I need to choose, I will change Fabio for him because on the paper, Fabio needs to struggle a little bit more in this track on the paper. Later, you know, he's so talented and for sure he will save it, but I will change Fabio for Pecco.
Okay, So actually, just before we came on here, I was talking with one of
Okay.
our friends in the office called Liam, and we were discussing whether the new chicane might help Fabio around here and the Yamaha's lack of top speed. Do you think that could help or not?
I think could help. It's true that after turn three is a big straight with that Ducati there normally have a advantage, and also Aprilia, that they are really fast on the straights also now, and they have a good device, a rear device, and all this. But I think, I think this choice is not bad. But looks, I read some things from Fabio that maybe the layout, the new layout, is not good for them. But I think will be a little bit better with the new
Okay.
chicane and less top speed, so can help him. But we'll see. Will be
I guess we'll
a
see
question mark for
after.
everybody.
Exactly. We'll see after FP1, really. If Fabio's at the top, then we
Exactly.
know he was lying. But,
After FP3, better.
okay.
Because FP1 will
FP3.
be also a little bit like this.
For sure. So, what that then gives us, Alex, is our team value's gone up, gone down a tiny bit, and we have now 700,000 to spend on a second change. Now, of course, we could change Ennea Bastianini or Marco Bezzecchi or maybe Aleix. Or if you wanted to change your constructor, you could. Obviously, you are a Honda rider. But for the riders, if we looked at 700,000, so if you wanted to change Ennea Bastianini, anyone under 3.7 million and below would be fine. So there's quite a few
I will
options.
change Bezzecchi
Or
for
Marco
me.
Bezzecchi. For yourself, okay, that's fine.
Bezzecchi for
Right,
myself, because I think here
you're
last
two
year we
points in.
had a good track for us.
Yeah.
It's true that we have a different bike, but
Well,
looks on the paper that can be not bad.
that's something I wanted to ask you, Alex. Actually, obviously, completely new bike this year. We know it's been a difficult season so far, but what do you think from kind of all the data you've gathered? Is it something that could work well here?
Looks yes, but I mean always is a question mark. It's on the paper. Later on, when you are on the track, it's always quite different. So on the paper, looks like we have many straight break points that we are not bad. Also accelerations, straight accelerations that we are also not bad. Not really corners that you really need to turn. I will say just the sector three. We'll see if we can lose less time there and we can. Be fast there, and yeah, looks on the paper that can be a not bad track for Honda.
Okay, well, fingers crossed that it is a good track for Honda because we know that this year's been difficult.
Also, we cross my fingers, believe
And
me.
well, we all will be. But one of the things that we just wanted to ask you as well was about last year's race in Austria, the second one, that crazy race where it started to rain with a few laps to go. There is some rain predicted this weekend. We're not too sure if it's going to be all day or just a sprinkling, but I'm sure you would prefer a less dramatic race than last time.
No, it can be even more better, believe me. In the
Yeah.
situation that we have, and normally on wet, we are quite fast and we have a good base. If it's rain, will be a good opportunity for us. From here to the end, we need to take that opportunities. We need to be smart. Okay, later if rain and you don't have the feeling, this depends the track and this, but all the possibilities are more open. On dry, we're struggling a lot now, and the possibilities are much less than a wet or crazy race. So was a nice wasn't a really nice race, but the last four laps, I mean, was like was really difficult to be on the bike straight, honestly. But the worst thing that three corners to the end, they start to overtake us, the guys that going in with the wet tires. So we were there in P4, P5, but later they overtook us. So yeah, but was a nice race for us, and I mean was a I think for the show was one of the greatest races from last year.
Yeah, for sure. It was a crazy race to watch. That's absolutely for sure. But we fingers crossed for you this weekend, Alex. That's well, actually, sorry, I forgot one thing. Before we let you go, there's one Mottl 300V boost remaining that we have three allocated for the year, and we've only got one left. Basically, what it does, it doubles the points scored of any rider that you choose. So you can choose one rider in your team. So say if you really think one particular rider is going to win this weekend, and you think absolutely they're going to get the 25 points, I'm going to double them. So is there anyone that stands out?
Okay, I will put to Pecco.
You want to do it
Like
for Pecco, yeah?
here, yeah, like here on the screen, I saw it is rider on fire, and when you are on
Yes.
fire, you know, doesn't matter the conditions, doesn't matter. Also, he's really fast on wet, so yeah, I think he's the guy on the form to try to win. I was thinking about Pecco or Enea because Enea also is in a really good form, but I will choose Pecco. I think is a little bit in a better way in these last races.
Okay, so we've boosted Pecco. Of course, Pecco this weekend going for 3 wins in a row. Let's see if he can do that. And it seems that Alex Marquez, you have elected him to do that. So good luck to Pecco. And then also good luck to you this weekend. Obviously, we hope it's a better weekend for Honda as you think it would could be. So good luck this weekend and just enjoy the race.
Thank you. Thank you so much, and bye, everybody. Thank
Thanks, Alex. Thank you.
you.
So then, this is going to be Alex Marquez's team for this weekend for the British GP. Sorry, not the British GP. That was a couple of weeks ago. The Austrian GP this weekend, round 13. In the end, then he's gone for Aleix Espargaró. We kept him there in gold. He traded out Fabio Quartararo interestingly and brought in Pecco Bagnaia. Not a bad trade at all, as Pecco has won the last two races and is the man with the momentum at the minute in the 2022 MotoGP World Championship. But as we do say, Alex also said himself that possibly it could just be that Fabio is helped out a little bit by the new layout this weekend, although Fabio doesn't think so himself. We remained with Aprilia, Enea Bastianini in there. As Alex rightly pointed out, he's just got a little bit of confidence back this weekend and from this performance last weekend. So certainly the beast, already 3 victories in 2022. Not going to be a bad shout to maybe pick up a fourth. And then we've gone for Alex himself as well. Of course, Alex tipping that Honda could have a better weekend than we've seen in the previous. And we do hope so, because we need Honda back towards the sharp end. So that's going to be the team then. Of course, the boost on Pecco is really banked on giving it Pecco the 3 wins in a row. So we'll see if we can do it. If you're not signed up to MotoGP Fantasy already, make sure you do. It's really easy. Just head to fantasy.motogp.com, input all your details, create your team name, and then input your dream team that you want to do. And if you can, well, if you manage to be quite lucky this weekend and score some pretty good points, if you head over to the prizes, this is the sort of things you'll be playing for to be able to win this weekend. Of course, those playing from the start of the season already know the drill with all these prizes that are up for grabs. But if you sign up this weekend, you play for the first time with the Austrian GP weekend, and you nail it, then you could win yourself 2 tickets to any Grand Prix of your choice. So that's going to be it then. Thank you very much for joining me for the 13th MotoGP Fantasy Preview Live of this season. This is the team that Alex has gone for. Good luck to him this weekend, and a very good luck to everyone else out there. Hopefully, we see the rain hold off a little bit longer than it did last year. That's it then. Thank you very much for watching. Enjoy the weekend.